Number 5. The Indian Navy will become the second navy in the world to deploy the Advanced Electromagnetic Aircraft Launch System to launch planes from its aircraft carriers and the advanced arresting gear to recover these planes. The U.S. Department of Defense recently approved the sale of these sophisticated systems to India. The second carrier in the Vikrant-class and India's first supercarrier, the INS Vishal, is in the design phase and will deploy both Emals and AAG. In this video, Defense Updates breaks down the technologies for the easy understanding of the viewers and analyzes their advantages. Number 4. There are mainly three ways of launching aircrafts from a carrier. 1. Ski jump, most primitive system, is used in current Russian, Chinese and Indian carriers. 2. Steam catapult, semi-advanced system, used in current Nimitz-class aircraft carrier of the United States Navy. 3. Electromagnetic aircraft launch system, state-of-art system, being installed in United States Ford-class supercarrier, which will replace some of Nimitz-class carriers. Let us now understand how these systems compare against each other. Ski jump aircraft carriers generate their airspeed from the run-up distance on the deck of the aircraft carrier and an assist from the ski jump. Ski jump aircraft carriers have limitations regarding how much ordnance can be loaded on the aircrafts. Steam catapult aircrafts of similar category can carry 3 times as much as payload compared to ski jump aircrafts. Steam catapult requires a lot of steam piping, a large condensate return, and tons of fresh water. They also have a lot of maintenance issues. Plus, with steam actuation, the majority of the force is being transferred to the airplane at the beginning of the stroke, in a jolt. This puts stress on an airframe, and thus reduces lifespan of the multi-million dollar planes. Emals uses linear induction motor with an electric current to generate a magnetic field. That field then propels a carriage down a track. Since the power delivery is linear, it negates the deficiencies of steam catapult. It's also lighter than a steam catapult system and cheaper to operate. Number 3. The hydraulic arresting system is installed in American Nimitz aircraft carriers, the French Charles de Gaulle, the Russian Kuznetsov, the Brazilian Sao Paulo, the Chinese Liaoning, as well as the Indian Vikram-Aditya. Hydraulic arresting system is designed for traditional carrier-based aircrafts. AAG is capable of working with all current and projected future carrier-based aircraft, from the lightest unmanned aerial vehicles to the heaviest manned fighters. It also allows for increased sortie rates, lower energy consumption and a decreased gross ship weight. Number 2. INS Vishal is the follow-on class of aircraft carrier currently in its design phase, which will be built by Cochin Shipyard Limited for the Indian Navy. It is intended to be the first supercarrier to be built in India. The proposed design of the second carrier class will be a new design, featuring significant changes from INS Vikrant, including an increase in displacement, and proposals to incorporate nuclear propulsion apart from Emals and AAG. Number 1. Both Emals and AAG are being developed by General Atomics, and require the U.S. Department of Defense approval for export to other countries. The Indian Navy in November 2016 confirmed plans to integrate Emals and AAG into its future supercarriers, by revealing the dispatch of letters of request to the U.S. DoD to buy these systems. The approval indicates the growing stature of U.S. and Indian partnership, and willingness on part of United States in sharing high-tech military systems with India. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. Kindly provide your feedback in the comment section, this will help us improve.